guys. Murloc68 here. Hope everybody's doing well today. Got a Brinks. Now, I featured one of these before, which was this one here. It's a really nice lock. Tough as hell to pick for me, anyway. One of the few locks that comes with 12 security pins right from the factory. This one here does have a bit of a problem. Wow. Look at that. It's opening a little better now, and I can't understand why. And that makes you look like an idiot. But anyway, it was not opening that smoothly a while back. You can still tell it has a bit of a hesitation, but if it opens like that, there you go. I'll be happy, but I'm not stuck a pick in it, so we'll see what we can do if I can get into it. Not easy locks for me, not ashamed to say it either. I have to go to the Chris Capoon School of American Lock. Anyway, let's give it a shot. Let's see what we can come up with. Like I said, 6-pinner. Very nice to see right out of the factory. That's pin 4, click. Trying to keep the tension light. One of my biggest downfalls with these locks. If you're dealing with serrated pins of any sort, they don't respond very well to heavy tension. And if they decided they were going to put serrated spools in it, for those of you not familiar, it's called a spool. If you can just picture a spool of thread, that's exactly what it is. So there's many, many kinds. And if they use the ones that have serrations in them, you're not going to get that pronounced false set that you would typically get with a spool, depending on how shallow or how deeply cut the spool was. So yeah. These are notorious for having heavy spring tension on the core. So to set your tension, you've got to make sure that you get by that first. Just sneak by. What I mean by that is you just want to turn it enough to overcome that. This way you know that you're now going to get your pins to bind up. So you can attempt to get in. Was 5, 6. So I'm gonna double check that one. Click. Those clicks are indications, because they're incremental clicks, that you're dealing with serrated pins, no doubt. Even the key pins would be serrated. Just gonna switch for a second here. Tension's still fairly light for for this core. Let's switch here. Be a bit heavy. Although it's a serrated spool, there still is that small amount of counter rotation that you gotta be wary of. A click there out of 5. Pin 5. Okay, I'm going to lower that finger just a little bit. Definitely have serrated spools. I don't know if it's consistent for them to use it. I know that American, I mean, this is no different than this American A15 key. It's still the same keyway. Key fits, should fit anyway. But they may set up a little differently inside. I know that American uses a lot of straight serrated pins as well as the serrated spools, so I know for sure we've got at least 3 serrated spools here. Causing way too much. Okay. I felt the tiniest movement there. You see my finger moving, I'm just testing the tension. Two clicks out of 2. 3 clicks. Huh. Very strange. Number 2, maybe it's just a serrated pin, not a serrated spool. Again, guys, this is all going by feel. You know, I could be totally wrong. But if you've picked enough of them, you're gonna be able to draw some conclusions when you're picking, right? trying to get under pin four here. There's a click. Just position that tension wrench. Just gonna let off just a little bit here. And when I did that, two drop, I believe. So close, but so far away. Check pin one. No, that's no good. Tension wrench almost flew out on me there. Yeah, just as I suspected, it was not going to be an easy one. Let's go way to the back here. There. Almost abandoned ship. Yeah, two feels like just a, instead of a spool, a serrated pin, which are also pigs to pick. I can feel it. I can feel the core just advancing slightly. It doesn't want you to get too excited, you know? I feel like I'm missing something right on position two, or pin two. Take my time here. As I was saying, that it's we've got to sometimes pick locks that we think tend to get the better of us, and I think the only way you're going to advance is if you keep picking them. It's a great lock. I love it. Trying to find my place here. Sure that tension wrench is where it's got to be. Just gonna do a quick shift over here for a second. Feeling something on position five. Okay, it's definitely position five. close, but so far away. Okay, I'm gonna try this again from this side. I feel like I am right there. I wonder if I could get this guy in there. Guys, this guy wants a fight, so we gotta fight. Buckle up. Let's see what's gonna happen here. I don't know why I can't set that pin. Something else here. Well, that didn't work out well. Did not work out. not go well. Thought I had some progress there. I think I inadvertently grabbed two pins at once. These pins are tiny. So it's pin number two again now. Because it dropped on me. I counter rotated that core. What a pick. Okay, I've got two set again. I keep dropping it. Trying to get back to the back here. Stonewalled, that's what you're getting. That's what you're getting, stonewalled. That's what that's called. You are getting stonewalled. Thank you. What a lock. Well, it's a war, guys. What are you going to do? Right? Somebody in the back here. And I got it open. So now, I don't want to lose it. There it is. Got it open, and of course, I've got to deal with this shackle now. The shackle that's not releasing, of course. There it is. What a war. Yeah, well, that's what it took, guys. So unfortunately, got it. That was pin number 4 that actually gave me counter rotation. So let's see. I'm really interested in pin number 2, the driver. I'm almost feeling 5 serrated spools and 1. I'm going to lock that up. We've got the key there. And 1 regular serrated, and that was 2 because it was giving me those extra clicks. But again, like I said, you go by feeling. You just never know. I could be way off. But anyways, I'm happy to get that open. It's another school day. I've had many, many school days in my lock picking days. Okay, so there's 6 pins, like I said, right off the bat. Let's have a look. Okay. I'm going to show you that. Okay, so everybody had to be picked. Let's see what we got. I'm anticipating the serrated key pins. Yeah, 1. 2, 3, 4. Wow, even the tiniest one they went in serrated. That is interesting. Okay, so let me just straighten these out. We've got 6 serrated key pins, guys. Talk about getting roughed up, and then you got to deal with possibly losing the open because you can't get, well, I mean, it would just be a mental thing for me if I couldn't get the shackle open, even though it was clearly the lock was open, but still. Wow. It's interesting there. Pin number 4 was nasty. Had to go right up into the ceiling. So let's have a look. Position 1. Yeah, serrated spool. Copper spring. Here's the one I'm interested in. Position 2. Wow, that was a heavy pop. Yeah, multiple serrations, guys. Copper spring. See if we can keep this under 2 hours, this video. Appreciate you guys sticking by, but when all the locks get done first time, unless I tell you it's rehearsed. So pin number 4, serrated spool again. I just lost something there. Okay, pin number 5, serrated spool as well. Let's see if we can get that spring out of there. There we go. And pin number 6 should be another serrated spool. And it is. With another copper spring, guys. The full Monty, so to speak, on this one, guys. 12 security pins, 5 serrated spools. And now that I pay closer attention, there you go. There's driver number 2 there. Multiple serrations. I'll take a close up. Again, I thank everyone for supporting me. Take a look at this nasty, nasty key. It's a nice gatekeeper there. Take a look at pin 4. That was that short, short pin that needed to go right into the ceiling. Patience, practice, perseverance, guys, on this. Brinks took me to town, but eventually I got into the vault. Stay well. I'll add some pictures. See you at the next one.